full name Ullapu-Kebir is a melee weapon for Demoman. It's obviously a German grenade. It's meant to be thrown, but Demoman instead hits people with it. First hit to an enemy will cause grenade to explode, plus you deal melee damage. Explosion and melee hit combined can deal up to 130 damage, but when it put to use, you usually deal less damage than 125. Kebir's stats have a lot of red text, 20% slower firing speed, deploys 100% slower, no random crits, the first hit will cause an explosion. Also deals self-explosion damage, which is about 55. Let's start with the deploy speed. Most of the time, melee weapons are used in a last-ditch fight, but 100% slower deploy speed makes Kebir super slow, ending up getting you killed in such a scenario. Here's a fun fact, reloading a single pill takes less time than pulling out the Kebir. 20% slower firing speed. When you left click with a melee weapon, after the animation, it will shoot out an invisible bullet, deciding if you hit or did not hit your target. 20% slower firing speed means between left click and the invisible bullet there is 20% more time delay. This sounds like a very small thing, but when put to use, it becomes obvious that you miss more often with the Kebir. Switching the Kebir already takes a lot of time. Slower firing speed just makes it feel even slower. No random crits, sounds like no big deal, but actually it is. TFT has different random crit chances for melee and non-melee weapons. Here's the chart. So, if a Demoman hits 3 of his pills and pulls out his bottle, he will have 1 in 3 chance of getting a crit. Knowing that melee weapons are often used in a last-ditch effort, taking that chance will be much better than using Kebir. Kebir has very unreliable damage output, plus it hurts you in the process. Kebir is stupidly bad. Only effective way to use Kebir is to get a shield that will let you crit with it. Oh, by the way, you cannot mini crit Kebir with the shields. Even then, slow turn speed with the shield, self damage, being stuck with an useless melee afterwards. Kebir is just useless. It wasn't used to be like this. Kebir was very powerful, too powerful, dealing 185 damage, easily one-shotting a light class. People would use sticky jumper and shields to absolutely terrorize the enemy team. Kebir needed a nerf, but when Valve nerfed something, they make it useless. That's what they did. They nerfed it till no one wanted to use it anymore. That's why Kebir needs a fix. We can't simply remove the nerfs, Kebir needs an overhaul. I think I have a good idea. Making Kebir the ultimate utility melee for the Demoman. First question we have to answer is, should Kebir be able to one-shot kill light classes? And I would say, yes. Kebir should be able to deal at least 125 damage. Classes that have 125 HP are Scout, Spy, Sniper and Engineer. Scout is already very fast and will be very hard for Demoman to catch up. Spy most of the time is disguised or invisible. Sniper snipes people from afar, and Engineer sits behind his sentry and teammates. Only one class would kinda have bad time, and that's Sniper. Demoman can use Sticky Jumper to quickly get to him and one-shot kill with the Kebir. This doesn't make the Kebir broken. In the end, Demoman has a grenade launcher that can deal 100 damage with no damage fell off. Another bad stuff about the Kebir is that it becomes useless after the first hit. Kebir should be able to regenerate with ammo packs, so you don't have to run back to the spawn. And finally, I asked myself, what kind of melee does Demo need? Demo has lots of swords, and all of them requires you to use shield. I wanted a new melee that doesn't require a shield and let you play stock Demoman. Here's my Kebir fix idea. When Kebir is pulled out and isn't exploded yet, Demoman walks faster, marked for death when active. Remove this 20% slower firing speed, reduce the deploy speed reduction to 50%. When killed and the Kebir is pulled out, Kebir will explode. Explosion plus melee hit will at least deal 125 damage. Kebir will charge in 40 seconds or by getting ammo packs. And lastly, no random crits. Now we have a nice utility melee for Demoman, allowing you to get to the action quicker. And when you run out of ammo, Kaber becomes a perfect last-ditch weapon. Even if you die, you will explode, dealing explosion damage to nearby enemies. Thanks to the faster move speed, you can smack someone and take them out with you, or you can just run away. Use it like an escape plan. This way, Kaber is no longer useless or overpowered. Well, some might think it's overpowered with my fixed version of Kaber, but I say against it. Demoman will die super quickly when Kaber is pulled out, knowing that power jack and escape plan exist. I don't think Kaber would be overpowered. High risk, high reward. Also, can we fix the Kaber's taunt? Thanks.